Hey guys, Scott, Killer Minis Painting and Gaming. Today we're going to do some D&D Spiders by Wizkids, Fabulous Nolzur's Miniatures. So, we'll start right off with a base coat. Now, I've had success with these. They come pre-primed. I've had a lot of success washing them first, letting them dry before I apply my first layer of paint. So this one is game color, wolf gray is what I laid down, mostly just about all over the model, kind of to use kind of like a primer, but I wanted to have actual paint down on. Yeah, then we grab the Army Painter Quick Shade Strong Tone, and we're going to apply what I like to call a pre-wash. And this kind of is my own term, it's just something you can throw down on a prime miniature so you can immediately see the details, just to make sure there's not something you're missing. This really helps getting your mind's eye to see the figure instead of one big blob of color. Get a little contrast between the low spots and the high spots of the figure. So here you can see a lot of the texture that's in the body and in the head of the spider. And you can start to see some of the little bit of detail on the legs that's meant to kind of like be like the fur, I guess. But so yeah, you can just kind of slap this all around. I kind of got a little bit finicky with it, making sure it wasn't pooling in certain areas. So for those of you new to the channel, by the way, let's do a little promoing. Thanks for joining me, and yeah. Feel free to whip out your brushes and paint right along. With the beauty of video, you can always just watch the video back once you get the models and the paint and try your hand at it, see how it works out. Or you can just use this as reference or just kind of hear me babble and watch me paint. So, yeah, that's my thing. So if you haven't subscribed, make sure you do by now, dude. What are you waiting for? Subscribe, dude. That's my thing. But sorry, it's late and I'm loopy. Here is where we're at now after the wash is pretty much all applied. I gotta say, I'm really digging these Wizkid figures. They're like $3 for a blister. You get like normally two or three monsters in there, so it's roughly $1 figure. You can't beat that. And we all know how their pre-paints were. So obviously you can do better than the pre-paints. So continuing on here with this pre-wash, I'm really being a little bit more finicky than I need to, because again, it is only a pre-wash. I think at the time I was thinking it was going to be a regular wash. So here is, after it dries, we're going to grab Vallejo Charred Brown, and we're pretty much going to put this all over the model, except for some of the bending appendages of the legs. I'm not sure what you call those. The spider knees. They have a lot of knees, man. Knees and elbows. But so yeah, just kind of keeping it pretty thick. Only applied a little bit of water to thin it out, but not too thin. Want to do this in one coat. You can see we're just dropping it, like I said, everywhere except for where the legs bend, and even in some spots underneath it. So if you don't have, if you haven't noticed, I'm using palette paper there. I really do like that because it's slippery and it just kind of feels the way paint does when you're painting paint. So here's the three with that charred brown. And that's really your primary base coat now done and complete. So we're going to grab the Beastie Brown and we are going to start basically layering up the color. And I'm going to use mostly an overbrush technique and a little bit of dry brushing, and sometimes I'm going to mix both of those together. So this particular brown is just a little bit lighter than that original charred brown. Got my paper towel ready and I'm all like, okay, I'm totally going to dry brush this, and I started realizing, nah, I'm really going to overbrush it. So here I'm just trying to get most of the paint out, but it's not all out. And as you can see, as I apply it, that really you're just kind of smearing it in the area. Kind of scrubbing it in some spots. Then once the paint starts to run out on the brush, you can dry brush in other areas. That's kind of what I've done here. You can always go back and reapply if you need to. There really is no specific recipe. That's the beauty of doing dry brushing or overbrushing. It really is. It's kind of freeing because it's such an easy technique. Doesn't mean that you can't get amazing results, and that's what I'm going to show you today. That if you layer the colors up instead of using, you know, some more difficult techniques, you can get the same effect. And there you go. So now there's some spots that are a little lighter than that original brown. That's kind of what we are going for. Now we're going to grab this leather brown, which is the next step up. It's got a little bit more yellow in it. Same thing. Rub off the brush. And here you can really see it kind of smearing in there. I'm really just kind of painting it. And that's where the overbrush comes in. It's unlike a normal just applying paint. And there actually did it directly. You just take a little bit of the paint out of the brush. Once you do it a few times, you'll see what I mean. You just do like you do when you dry brush, but leave a lot more paint on the brush. Simple as that. But this, I did try to apply it in a little less of the surface area, more of a highlight. So now we're going to grab the desert sand, and we're going to take that tone that we just had, and we're going to bring that a little brighter. You can see me mixing it up, trying to get my mind's eye to agree with the next shade, rubbing it off, and boom, you start to see some brightness there. That's what we're looking for. I'm going to apply that a little bit more sparingly than we did with the other colors, obviously. And yeah, trying to get some of the contours of that body to stick out. Then we're going to hit the knees. Yep. Desert sand again. Now this time it's going to be almost pure desert sand. We're going to add in a little bit of that original color, but we're really going to knock it up a notch for sure. Because I wasn't happy with the pop. I wanted a little bit more pop. There you go. You can see I'm really dabbing it. That's total overbrush. I rubbed some off. This is more of a dry brush, but still overbrushing. You can tell because if you're not whisking back and forth, like you do with a makeup brush. So there it is, where we're at so far. And now I'm going to go pure desert sand, and I'm just going to paint in basically some areas of the face. I'm using a number one Winsor & Newton Series 7, I believe. And you can see, I was trying to get the details out of these little tendril things in the side of its head. And at this point, I was really kind of confused, like, what color am I going to throw down there? But I did know I wanted to get some contrast, because this desert sand was just blending in with everything else. And, hey, it's all up to you. You can do it that way if you want. It's your paint job. But for me, I wasn't feeling it. I needed to get some differentiation between the legs and the body. So I grabbed some of that Army Painter Crusted Sore. It's a purple. And diluted it just a bit, but enough to keep it thick to where I can control it. I went ahead and started laying some paint down with that number one brush on the tendrils and even some areas of the face. And I kind of like that look. Later on, I actually changed it more to a red, but I started with a dark purple. You have to be careful with this purple, because if you overspill, right? If you go outside the lines, baby, it's going to go on all that hard work. You can always just paint right back over it. So now I grab some demonic yellow from Army Painter, and to be honest, that's not the strongest paint in their line. Every time I grab it, I'm like, why did I put this on my palette? I really dislike that yellow. I don't know. It seems like it goes on nice and bright, and then it just dull. Dark tone Army Painter wash. So yes, we're doing a wash next. I felt good with all those layers of dry brushing. Now I want to bring back all the details that I brushed over. That is the downside of the overbrushing. It's going to cover up some details. So you want to definitely use it mostly in flat surfaces and areas that have a lot of texture, like on the body of that spider. So as I laid this black wash down on the legs, I started like, hey, this kind of has this tarantula effect, this striping in the legs. I really liked it. I liked it so much that I knew that once the wash dried, it was going to be a little too dull for my taste. So anyhow, we'll get to that in a minute, but here's all three of them that I did up. This is what came in the blister. And yeah, once you paint one, it's easy just to grab the one right next to it, and you already got the color in your palette. You just knock them out real quick. And instead of getting one done, you got three. So here, technical difficulties, I lost the footage of what I did next because I made some changes. But like I said, I really like that black striping. So now it's dry, but it's still super shiny. Oh my God, what did I do? Well, basically I just took some black paint, went over those areas that I enjoyed with the wash, and then I tossed on a gloss varnish, and that will give it a glossy appearance. And that's the look we got. So here's the pure black, it's a Reaper color. I just put that into the same spots where I was washing, where I got the striping. I really like that look, a tarantula effect, so to speak. And where's my gloss varnish? You should have some gloss varnish laying around. This is a good thing to have in your toolbox. You can use it for gems, anything you want to be super shiny, right? Now, if we do a matte varnish later, it will knock it back, and you have to put it back on later, but I wasn't planning on varnishing these. So I may have to rethink that, because if I decide to stock my dungeon full of these deadly spiders, well, I might get my Gaiman fingers and my Frito fingers all over it. So here is a zoom. I got some yellow and red up into the face. If you look clear, it's not really purple. So it is a darker red. I used a Citadel color this time. Blood for the Blood God. The reason why I picked this is because it's a very shiny paint. It has, I believe it has a gloss medium in it. It dries gloss. And so it eliminated a step for me. So I went ahead and used it. And the yellow still wasn't really there for me. So I ended up using Flash Gets Yellow from Citadel. And I love that yellow. That yellow is the bomb. So it's a little hard to see in the lighting there. That one I might have put it on a little light. I'm going to grab another model here to show you the yellow. Where are we at? Up. Here's the two paints that I used. I did have to basically reapply a little bit of dry brushing to the knees of the legs. Felt like I kind of left that out a little bit. So yeah, I did the yellow to the eyes and a little bit to like the fangs. And then I brought some of the red too on the bottom of it. Let's see if you can make it out. And that's the finished product. So thanks guys. I hope you appreciate. I'm loving it. Hope you're loving it. Give me a thumbs up. Let your friends know, hey, I'm doing videos. I exist. If you haven't subscribed, dude, hit that subscribe button. What are you waiting for? If you already are, man, I appreciate you. I love you. We'll see you in the next video, guys. Killer Minis, double pieces on the way out.